Welcome to another analysis video from Learn.Invest.Achieve channel. Today we will learn the two reasons that caused Google stock to go down by about 12% after filing the 2022 annual report, even though that the company reported a growth in revenue. So I think we have to update the intrinsic valuation number for 2023 because we have the 2022 report. But before we do that, I want to remind you that this video is not financial advice and is for entertainment purposes only. In this channel, we heavily depend on the annual reports to use the financial and non-financial information that help us to find the intrinsic value of the stock. So I went over the 2022 annual report and a number of prior years' reports that I downloaded from the SEC website directly by using one of the ticker symbols of the company, and from this section, I can view and download all the annual and quarterly reports. And this is something that I suggest you do as well in your free time if you like to learn more about the businesses that you want to invest in. And in this Excel file, we collect all the data that we need to find the intrinsic value of Alphabet stock. This company is a multinational and multi-business company that generates revenue from ads, cloud services, and selling hardware products like Pixel phones, Fitbit, and Google Nest home products. The company has three equity securities or three classes of stocks. And they are Class A with a ticker symbol GOOGL that has one vote per share, Class B that has 10 votes per share and it's not traded in the stock market, so there is no ticker symbol for this one, Class C stock with a ticker symbol GOOG and has no voting power. So it's obvious the majority of the voting power is within the Class B stocks because it has 10 votes per share versus 1 vote per share or no votes for the other two classes. And if you go back to the annual report, we can learn that the majority of the Class B stock is owned by Larry Page and Sergey Brin, who are the founders of Google. Together, they own about 86% of Class B stock, which is about 51% of the voting power. So they have a significant power over all the decisions made and therefore the direction of the company. In my opinion, I don't think we have to worry about the significant influence of the founders because so far, Google have been doing very great under their leadership. Going back to the Excel file, Alphabet reports its operation in a fiscal year that ends on December 31st. And in the 2022 annual report, they have a clean auditor report. This means that the external accounting company that audited the financial statements didn't find any issues, so we can trust the financial statements and assume everything in it is true. Over here, I collected the financial data from all three financial statements, the income statement, the balance sheet statement, and the cash flow statement. And in the blue rows, I have formulas to calculate the ratios that we need in this analysis. Looking at the 2022 revenue, 79% came from Google Advertising, 10% Google Other, that is the hardware products, Google Play Store, and YouTube non-advertising revenue, and 9% of 2022 revenue came from the cloud services. And geographically, the United States are Alphabet's largest market, then Europe, the Middle East, and Africa. After that, Asia Pacific, and lastly, Canada and Latin America. Next, we look at the revenue for the past few years that is represented in the orange line, and we can notice that it's growing every year. Also, we can see that the growth of the cost of revenue and operating costs is growing naturally with the revenue, which is something we are glad to see. The gross margins are 20 to 31%, which is very good news for Google. Scrolling down to the free cash flow, we also can notice that it's positive for all the past few years since 2015 and is growing every year. But in 2022, it shows some slowdown because it's lower than 2021. $67 billion in 2021 versus $59.9 billion in 2022. And in my opinion, this is the first reason behind the stock losing about 12% of its value since Alphabet published the 2022 report about a week ago. Moving on to the debt to asset ratio. This must be one of the lowest ratios I have ever seen because in the past 3 years, ratio is only 4%. In other words, only 4% of the assets are funded by debt, which is an amazing achievement. Because this means that the business generates so much cash that they don't need to borrow to invest for future growth. Scrolling down to the times interest earned ratio that tells us how many times the interest expense the company is making in earnings. And in 2022, Alphabet made about 245 times the interest expense, so we don't have to worry about the company's solvency. Moving on to the outstanding shares, I'm sure you'll like the fact that the company is repurchasing its stock every year since 2018, and they bought about 8% of the outstanding shares since 2018 with an average of 1.6%. So we should consider this fact in our forecast. Dividend investors are not going to be happy that Alphabet's policy is to never distribute dividends because they want to reinvest every penny back in the business. And maybe this policy, along with high margins, resulted with a very low debt-to-asset ratio that's 4% as we saw earlier. Now we can move to the forecast part, and as usual, we experiment with different ratios to find a consistent one to use it to forecast next year revenue. Using the financial statements to forecast the revenue help us to get as close as possible to the actual revenue at the end of 2023. And in this case, we will choose the working capital to revenue ratio. We used this ratio in the last intrinsic valuation video for Google, and the revenue forecast in that video is 96% of the actual revenue in 2022, which is, in my opinion, very close to the actual. So that makes me confident about using the same ratio again, that's the working capital to revenue ratio, to forecast Alphabet's revenue. This ratio is increasing by about 13% every year, so we will increase the 2022 ratio by 13%. To have 2.58 working capital to revenue ratio for 2023, which means that each working capital dollar will generate about $2.58 in revenue. But the second issue we have is that Alphabet started 2023 with a lower than usual working capital. We can find the working capital by subtracting the current liabilities from the current assets, which represent the cash or the liquidity available to the company to run their operations in the next year. Therefore, and unfortunately, this ratio predicts a lower revenue for 2023 compared to 2022, because the working capital is lower than 2022. And actually, it's the lowest in the last 5 years. So in my opinion, the revenue forecast is about $246 billion, which is about 13% lower than 2022 revenue. This is the second reason that the stock lost about 12% since the 3rd of February. I know some of you will disagree, but the numbers don't lie. And if we take a look at the balance sheet, I think the reason that the working capital this year is the lowest since 2017, there is a $27 billion negative change in the marketable securities, causing the current assets to be $164 billion compared to $188 billion in 2021. And if we go back to the Excel file, I can show you the effect of that negative change. So if I add $27 billion to the working capital, we can see that the 2023 revenue will be $315 billion, but of course we have to stick with the numbers in the financial statements. Next is the free cash flow to revenue ratio, and this ratio tells us how much of the revenue will be free cash flow. And as we can see here, in 2022 it was 21%, so we can use the same ratio, or we can use the average for the past 4 years, that's 22%. Moving on to the forecast outstanding shares at the end of 2023, we will assume that they will buy back another 1.5% of the 2022 outstanding shares. For the discount rate, we will use the treasury bill interest rate, that's 4.47%. And if you want to know where to find this rate, please see Amazon intrinsic valuation video for 2023 right before this video. Finally, we will use 5% return on investment, but you can use any rate you think it fits better to your investment portfolio. So in my opinion, these 5 forecast keys will give us about $246 billion in revenue and $54 billion total free cash flow, which means $4.29 free cash flow per share, discounting it by 4.47%, and using 5% return on investment, it will give us about $81.98 intrinsic value for Alphabet stock. The current stock price is $94.57, and the day before making the annual report public to the investors, it was about $107. So actually the stock went down by about 12% since the 2nd of February, comparing with today's price. Please let me know what you think and how we can make this analysis better. And one last thing, big thanks for the people who subscribed, and I hope you consider supporting this channel by liking this video and subscribing to this channel.